The next type of pattern matching mechanism I want to use are what are called placeholders. And placeholders are different from repetition in that they don't match a character, they match a location. So if we have something where we had a plus here, this plus means I want to see more A's over and over and over again. But a placeholder is going to say, I'm matching between characters, that, or before characters, or after characters, rather than a specific character. So I'm going to go over two very important placeholders and just mention that there are others. The first one that I want to review is the caret. And the caret represents the begin and the beginning of what is a little bit ambiguous. In different regular expression languages, this may be the beginning of your full input, or it could be the beginning of a line of input. If your string has multiple lines, let's say you read an entire file, or let's say in a web context, it represents an entire text area where they have multiple lines of input. It can represent either the beginning of the text box or the beginning of a particular line in a text box. But in general, when you look on the web, people don't oftentimes distinguish between those two. It represents the beginning. And so then we can have some text here. Now this regular expression is subtly but very importantly different from the regular expression without that caret. In here we say we want the input to start with the word text, whereas in this regular expression without the caret we say I want to find text somewhere in the string that I'm doing the pattern match against. There's no placeholder that we need to match, and so the regular expression engine, when it's looking for that text, can find it anywhere it wants. Here it only has one possible place that it could look. The corresponding placeholder to the caret is the dollar sign, which, as you can see by how I've drawn the regular expression, it represents the ending. And again, you have these two options. It could be the ending of your input, or it could be the ending of a particular line. And it's just as ambiguous as the caret is, depending upon the programming environment and what the people who are describing the input do. And so you caret and dollar sign are the most frequently used to represent both beginning of input and beginning ending of input, beginning of line and ending of line. And this works in the same way. Now what this means is not are we looking for text at the beginning of the input or just anywhere in the input, we're looking for it specifically so that when it happens, it's at the end of our input. And so this is the most general pattern, and so it's going to match many more things than the top one with the caret or the bottom one with the dollar sign. And then, of course, the most specific is to include both of these placeholders. Now, this is a really silly example for using a regular expression because we have begin, text, end. So this is only going to match the exact string equal to text. So this would be equivalent to doing a comparison to text. And again, it's not very useful. It's only useful if we do something in here with our repetition operators or with other operators that we're going to be talking about in future videos. However, I want to point this out because very frequently a common error that people make when they're using regular expressions is that they forget to include the caret and the dollar sign when they mean I want the input to be exactly this and nothing else. And they just do this regular expression instead. And they think that this means all of the input matches this. And that's not true. This just means that some of the input matches text. Whatever happened before it, whatever happened after it, might or not match. We don't care. We found a match somewhere in our input. Whereas this means that the entirety of our input matches this. And this is very useful when you're doing something like validation of an input field, where you want to see some very specific input. So for instance, a common example of that would be an email address. Or you could do any of the other things I did at the introductory thing. Dates and names and so forth. If you forget this caret and dollar sign, someone could be weird. They could even do some SQL or other types of injection in your, because your validation thinks it sees an email address, and they have done something where they've put a valid email as part of their input. But in addition to that, they've either on the beginning of the input and or at the end of the input, they've put other stuff in that input that doesn't match your regular expression. But because you don't have the caret to lop that off, and because you don't have the dollar sign to lop this off, those are missing. Let's write that missing. This extra text that's on here that you don't want to be a part of your validation will still evaluate to matching because of those missing characters. So very, very frequently in a web context, you want to have a caret, your regular expression that you're looking for, and a dollar sign to say that my entire input, everything about it, it matches this regular expression, not just a portion of my input matching this regular expression.